All right, on to number 79. So we're going to take our enthalpy formation, the standard state ones, and now we're going to use them to calculate heats of reaction, enthalpies of reaction, using these values. So what you have to know is it's really just products minus reactants. That's all. So in the back of the textbook, you're going to have these tables here in the appendix. This has all the different compounds and elements in there, but most importantly, you have to look at not only the compound, you have to look at the phase, because different phases require a different amount of heat to make them. So I already looked up in the back of the textbook all the values I need for number 79, so we can expedite this video right here. So for 79, they give you a bunch of, like, I don't know, diagrams here of compounds. You have to figure out what they are. So the first step is to write down the actual reaction. All right, so you have ammonia, NH3 gas. These are all, actually everything here is gas. I stopped writing. So you have two NH3 plus three O2s plus two CH4s and forms two hydrogen cyanides and two water, six waters. All right, they're all gases. All right, so away we go. To figure out your delta H for A, it's really just products minus reactants. But what you have to do is you have to take the values from the back of the book and you have to multiply them by how many moles of each one, because everything's in moles. So we have to figure this out. You have 2 moles of HCN. So HCN, I wrote down over here, is 135, requires 135 kilojoules. I'm not going to write the kilojoules. All right, but there's another product. There's 6 waters. So you take the 6 moles and you find the value for each water, which is negative 242 kilojoules per mole, and we have 6 moles. All right, that takes care of the product side. And you're going to subtract the reactant side. Now, there's 3 reactants here, so we handle the ammonia first. 2 times the value for ammonia, which is negative 46. All right, and we're going to combine that with our oxygen. But oxygen, if you remember now, the heat of formation is determined from the elements as they exist in their standard state. Well, O2 is already in the standard state, so it requires zero energy to get there. It's already there. So the O2 part is actually zero. So, and then we have just methane. So we have 2 moles of methane, which is negative 75. All right, and if you put this onto your calculator, your delta H for this reaction, and I'm just going to look up the answer because I don't have my calculator right next to me, 940 kilojoules, and sometimes you see it per reaction. All right, the trick to these, sometimes in the Zumdahl textbook, if there's a number that's more than 1, like 2 and 6, they'll just write kilojoules for the delta H. But if you look at letter C, there's 1 mole of reactant here, your delta H will say kilojoule per mole. And in the AP, they like to say kilojoules per reaction. So you just kind of adapt a little bit. It all pretty much means the same thing. All right, B. All right, so we have some calcium phosphate. We have some sulfuric acid. They're going to react to form calcium sulfate. And what is this? This is phosphoric acid. Actually, it's not phosphoric. It's hydrogen phosphate because these are liquids, and that's hydrogen sulfate. It's only an acid when it's in water. All right, so delta H, again, equals products minus reactants. Be aware of any elements. I do not see them here, which is good. So we just have to do our product side first. So we have 1 mole of calcium phosphate, and that is, wow, negative 4,162 kilojoules per mole. And we have 3 moles of the hydrogen sulfate, no longer sulfuric acid. It's not in water. All right, and that takes care of our, wait, that's the reactant side. Ah, I did it all backwards. All right, so, I'll just cross it out and just write it over here. 1, 4, 1, 2, 6, plus 3 and 8, 14, negative 8, 14. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I made that mistake. Oh, so embarrassing. All right, 3 times the calcium sulfate, 1,433, and that's negative. And the other product is the hydrogen phosphate, which is negative 1,267. All right, and you put it into the imaginary calculator I don't have, and I just look up the answer, and negative 265 kilojoules per reaction. All right, and the last one, we're taking ammonia. I'll rewrite the reaction. NH3, and we're reacting with hydrochloric acid. No, it's not hydrochloric acid. It's not in water. It's hydrogen chloride. We're forming solid ammonium chloride. All right. Usually this reaction is used to just demonstrate, I think it's Graham's law of effusion right here. All right, so products, we only have one. This is all balanced, so we need to look up the ammonium. So our delta H, products minus reactants, negative 314. And we have to subtract our reactants. So 1 times our ammonia was negative 46. And the other component was HCl, but you have to make sure it's HCl gas. Negative 92. And this delta H comes out to negative 176 kilojoules. And this is per mole now because it's one. All right, there you go. That was number 79. Hi, everyone. This is chapter 6, number 81. All right, I guess the Zumdahl edition 9. So it talked about the Ostwald process for making nitric acid. And what we got to do here is we got to use the heat of formations from Appendix 4 to figure out the delta H for each one of these three reactions. So in the back of the book, you have all these, I guess, tables here with all these compounds and elements along with their phases. So phases are very important for this. So when you do these, you got to do products over reactants. Very, very simple. You look up in the back and you do your delta H that way. So delta H for the first reaction. This is, I'll label them 1, 2, and 3. All right, so delta H for the first reaction. You got to remember it's products minus reactants. All right, so we have 4 moles of nitrogen monoxide, and 4 moles of nitrogen monoxide each have a value of 90 kilojoules per mole. All right, and we have 6 moles of water, but you got to watch out for the gas phase, and that one's 242 kilojoules per mole. So that takes care of the reactant side. Now we got to subtract the product side. We have 4 moles of ammonia right there, and that's in the gas phase, and that is negative 46. All right, so when you do your math here, products minus reactants, you got double negative there. All right, you end up with negative 908 kilojoules per reaction. All right, in the textbook, sometimes it'll just say kilojoules, because there's actually 10 moles of product here. If it says kilojoules per mole, that's only 1 mole of product. And you're not going to see these with any of those. So in reaction number 2, same thing. Delta H is products minus reactants. This time we have 2 moles of NO. And NO had the value, we got to start with this side. 2 moles of NO2. All right, and we got to start with that, and that is 34. That's in the gas phase. And then we do minus... Oh, did I mention that oxygen is left out because it's an element in the gas phase? So it's already there. This is the standard state of oxygen, so it doesn't have a value. All right, so we just did the products right there. We got to do 2 nitrogen monoxides. All right, and they had the value of 90 kilojoules per mole. And that's pretty much it for the reactants because there's O2 again in the gas phase. It doesn't have a delta H of formation because it's already there. It starts on the gas phase, ends up in the gas phase, doesn't matter. If it was liquid or solid, then we have a delta H for that. So for number two comes out to negative 112 kilojoules per reaction. And finally, number 3. All right, we got to do products minus reactants. I'll just jump into it. We have nitric acid. It's an acid. It is aqueous, so we have definitely have nitric acid right there. That is 207 negative kilojoules. All right, per mole. And we have to add that to 1 nitrogen monoxide, and that was 90 kilojoules per mole. So that takes care of the product side. The reactants, we have 3 moles of NO2. All right, so we have 3 moles, and that is 34 kilojoules per mole. And we got to add that to 1 mole of the liquid water. You got to make sure you use the liquid one because there's different versions of that. 286 kilojoules per mole. So that's your products, that's your reactants. Subtract that out and you get negative 140 kilojoules per reaction. All right, so on to 81B. Now this one is really tricky and I hope I don't screw it up when I try to explain it to you. All right, so you have your three reactions here, and there's a fourth one that we're going to bring in, the water. They talk about water in this right here. So what happens is you have 4 NH3 plus 5 moles of O2, and you're forming 4 nitrogen monoxides and 6 H2Os, and it's a gas, so you gotta just bear with me with that one. All right, so what happens is the 4 moles are consumed in the next reaction. So if you look at the next reaction, it's 2 NO plus O2 forms 2NO2. However, we have 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring this. I'm going to make this a 4. I'm going to make this a 2. I'm going to make this a 4. Because 4 moles, boom, going this one. Now, in the third reaction, you have 3 NO2s. And we have water. All right, and that's liquid. And then we have 2 HNO3s and 1 nitrogen monoxide. All right, now these 4 can't convert to 3. All right, so we need the common multiple of this, which is 12. So this we're going to have to multiply by 4. So this whole thing is going to be multiplied by 4, 4, 8, 4. Now we got to go back and do the same thing here. All right, this has to be now multiplied by 3. So this becomes 12, this becomes 6, and this becomes 12, which in turn has to come up to this one, which in turn becomes 12 multiply everything by 3, 18, 15, and 12. All right. And finally, the last part we have to do is we have to convert the waters to gas because the product is a gas. So we have 4H2O gas and 4H2O liquid, and that's going to be thrown in there. So what ends up happening when we add this all up, all right, let's see, these are going to drop out. That's good. We're going to just clean this all up. And what ends up happening is you got your 12 and H3s. You have 21 oxygens. All right, you have, let's see what else can clean up here. You have some NO2s that are gone. These are gone. These are gone. You have the oxygen we already did. That's there. We have 8 nitric acids. 8 nitric acids. We have 4 nitrogen monoxides. And then we have 14 gaseous waters because 18 minus 4 is 14 H2O gas. And that is a nasty, nasty question, but that's how you do 81B. Hope